Good evening, everyone. So this was one of the most difficult things I could do in my life, and I think everyone, most of the people in the audience would know it. Trying to keep myself concise, trying to sum it up in 20 seconds. So I think it was a good exercise. I think the last 2 weeks have been really tough on me, and I hope I would be able to bore people less after this event. So what a beautiful moment for me, standing here as a speaker at the Kolar Picha Kucha amidst all of you. My status, though, as an architect is somewhat imperfect. I do not smoke, do not booze, cannot boast of designer office, nor a collection of awards, and never visited Salone dei Mobili Milano. I'm a bit overwhelmed. From a balcony and bedroom window, I look at this every day. Is this not beautiful? I also see the construction all around, the seemingly imperfect formations being reduced and building the perfect iconic structures of today. That to me seems so imperfect due to what they have done to the entire landscape. We humans are the perfect creations of God, but not biologically. Some abnormalities are referred to as beauty marks and have created the most beautiful faces on screen. Imagine Marilyn Monroe without it and Rekha deciphered, only looking at it. The defects of muscle, facial muscles have given Deepika and Shah Rukh their cutest smiles. Most girls growing up have imagined the Barbie as their best friend, someone they wanted to be like, dress like. Her body proportions, though, are far from perfect. In fact, nearly impossible to have. On the contrary, a lady losing her figure to pregnancy is considered so beautiful. Growing up, we all heard, be like this, act like that, and somewhere we all were trying to fit frames through which the world would want to see us, the perfect one. But the human trait of being yourself scores above others. Trying to be perfect by putting on pretensions is not what we would honestly appreciate in a person. The not so perfect yet your true self is what defines inner beauty. Every tree is perfect in itself, and so is nature, but they are both ever changing, imperfect in that sense. Does beauty then lie in constant change? Is it something in beauty that we are missing by looking for it in an absolute or constant? Our own office is always in a state of chaos. For an outsider, at times, it would seem like the most inappropriate space and setting to churn out designs that seem to be perfect for our clients. So it makes me think both imperfections and perfections are at play here. Somewhere consciously, we started the process to perfect the designs of the offices for our clients, making them functionally efficient, cost-effective, and quick to execute. The clients kept coming back for more and more, and we had managed to sort of write a template with respect to plans, materials, and detailing in a manner that seemed to work in our favor. In came a client 3 years ago with an office project that made us alter all our templates, starting with an angular design to stripping the materials and color palette to a bare minimum. And believe me, not a square inch of white paint was used. A process imperfect by our own definition. And before we realized, our maiden entry for a design award had received commendation and acclaim. Certain definitions of beauty and perfect may not hold good for this proposed apartment design by architect Suyo Fujimoto in a Mediterranean city of France, but it so well captures the city's tradition of outdoor living. The huge tree-like appearance and balconies that fan outwards, much like leaves reaching for the sunlight, a beautiful break from the mundane. Creating a sense of harmony and balance between nature and architecture, Omotesando branches, a small four-story building, another of architect Fujimoto's creation. The three-dimensional garden on its facade, a micro version of vertical forest in densely built urban context, allows nature to cohabit in all the levels. When I select stone or veneer for regular stuff, I mostly use a lot of smaller grains and evenness. However, when I want to make a statement in design, I look for the most imperfect slab of stone or a veneer, to the extent that if it is seen by my client individually, it may get rejected. I stumbled upon this setting done by a watchman at a site. Looking at it, I realized how perfectly he had used the space and material. The bed of discarded gypsum partition over bricks, what an idea. The entire setting complete with all the basic needs of a bedroom and living room. Could not be more perfect for him and looked really cool to me. Isn't it completely opposite to the otherwise perfect settings we all look at? I'm wondering, was it the exhilarating experience of climbing the steep edge of the 200-meter-high Sikriya rock fortress in the company of friends, or the rock itself with its faded colorful frescoes and the ruins that once were the majestic capital and the royal palace that was beautiful. The moment I saw this video, I was like, please leave the vada alone. It doesn't need perfecting. We would like the vada straight from the hands of the master cook. The taste in every bite gives a different sensation and completes the beautiful experience. The imperfect physical objects surrounding us can become symbols of our diligence to find meaning due to the virtue-centric qualities of these objects. The handmade cards from my daughter and her drawings are some of my dearest treasures, despite their imperfections. In pursuit of perfect borders, it pains to see what's happening around the globe. So many countries, including ours, have suffered brutally. Generations have lived as refugees, lost their loved ones. Why not let these imaginary lines define the perfect geographical maps of countries and let them remain distorted to let peace prevail? What better than a literal meaning to this topic? Your TV presenter, Julia Bradbury, is drowning in a sea of plastic bottles, 750 to be precise. The number UK litters every minute. The perfect packaging at stores which catches our attention is then disposed in a manner that is shocking. Our entire planet is threatened. Finally, while I was deliberating on the topic and trying to understand beauty, perfection, imperfection, and its connectivity, I came up with this Venn diagram where everything seems to be interconnected with our perception and interpretation. So we can say every perception of perfection is subject to interpretation. In the last 19 slides, my monologue with you has been about perception and beauty in all its imperfections. However, as an architect, my tolerance levels to imperfection in my drawings and at sight tends to be zero. Does that make me ugly? For my vendors and staff, I would appear to be one demon chasing them towards perfection. Thank you.